Welcome to this walkthrough guide on how to extract comments from a Google Doc using AppScript. If you've ever worked on a collaborative Google Doc, you've probably faced this frustration. You have dozens, maybe hundreds of comments and replies, and there's no easy way to export them. You can't copy-paste them all, you can't archive them, and once you click Resolve, they're hidden away, making it basically impossible to create a clean archive of all the feedback. Now, what if you need to send all that feedback to a stakeholder, or keep a searchable record of all of the changes? Trying to manually copy every single comment is an absolute nightmare. Well, that's where this walkthrough comes in. I'm going to show you how to set up a completely free one-click tool inside Google Sheets that will instantly extract every single comment and reply from any Google Doc, and it will format it beautifully for you. The best part? This entire process stays within the Google Workspace ecosystem. There's no extra software to download, which is great for security, and you don't even have to know how to code. I'll be providing all of the code you need in a Google Doc, which I've linked in the description below. My code is also heavily commented, so you can see exactly what each line does. Now, we're going to walk through it at a high level in this video, so you can feel 100% comfortable with what this script is doing. Now, if you're new to Google Apps Script and you do want to deep dive into what it is and how it works, I highly recommend checking out my previous video on the basics, which I'll also link down below. But for today, you don't need any prior experience. You just need to follow along. So let's get this set up. First, we need a place for our comments to go. So we'll create a brand new Google Sheet that will act as the control panel and the destination for our exported data. So head to your Google Drive and create a new blank Google Sheet. Alternatively, simply head to sheets.new, which will create a new blank workbook for you. Let's go ahead and now give it a name. I'm going to call my one Comment Extractor. This single sheet is going to be all you'll need. You can reuse this same sheet to pull comments from any number of different Google Docs. Now, we need a way to access the engine room of this Google Sheet. Every Google Sheet has a powerful scripting tool attached to it called Google Apps Script. This is where we'll paste the code that does all the heavy lifting. In your new Comment Extractor sheet, click on Extensions in the top menu. From the dropdown, go ahead and select Apps Script. This will open up a new tab in your browser. This is the Apps Script editor. You'll see one default file called code.js. This is where we're going to add our magic. Our tool is broken into three small files to help keep it organized, and I want to explain what each one does so you know exactly what's happening. As I mentioned earlier, all this code is available in the Google Doc that I've linked in the description. First, let's rename the default code.js file. Just click the three dots next to it and select Rename. Let's call this one menu.js. Delete any code that's already in there and then paste in the code for menu.js from my shared document. So what's this file actually doing? Honestly, it's very simple. It contains one function called onOpen. This is a special built-in trigger for Google Sheets. It automatically runs only when you open the spreadsheet. All it does is get the spreadsheet's user interface, or UI, create a new menu item called Comment Extractor, add an item to that menu called Export Comments from Doc. And finally, it tells that menu item to run a function called Prompt for Doc URL when you click it. That's it. Basically, it's just creating a button. Next, we need to add our second file. Click the plus icon next to Files and select Script. Name this new file User Input. Go back to the code document, copy the code for userinput.js, and paste it into this new file. This file contains the prompt for doc URL function that our menu button is calling. As you can see, its first job is to get the UI to show you a prompt. That's the little pop-up box that's going to ask for the URL. It then checks if you clicked OK. If you did, it runs a little helper function at the bottom called extract docid from URL. This is a great example of keeping the code safe. This function uses what's called a regular expression. Basically, it's just a search pattern to look through the URL that you pasted in and find only the 44-character Google Doc ID. It's not interested in anything else. If it finds that ID, it passes it to our main function. If not, it just gives you a polite error message. All right, now let's add our third and final file. Click the plus icon again, select script, and name this one Comment Extractor. Copy the last, largest block of code from the shared document and paste it in here. This is the main engine, and as you can see from my comments, it's broken into four clear sections. Section one is where it fetches the data. It uses the drive comments list command to ask the Google Drive API for all of the comments. You'll see that we've asked it to fetch the created time along with the comment content and author. It then loops through all the comments and replies, and importantly, it converts that timestamp into a proper date object that Google Sheets can understand. Section two is where it writes the data. It organizes all the comments, replies, authors, and dates into a big list. Then it writes that entire list to the spreadsheet in one single operation using set values. Honestly, it's incredibly fast. Section three is all about making it look nice. This is where the script freezes the header row, sets the column widths, and applies some text wrapping. It also has a specific line to format our new date column into a clean, sortable format. Finally, it loops through and applies alternating background colors and borders. Section four is just the final export complete pop-up message. So, as you can see, there's nothing too out there here. It's all just fetching comments, writing them to the sheet, and making them look good. Now that we understand the code, let's save our project. But first, let's give it a name. I'm going to call mine Comment Extractor so that it matches my document. Now we click the Save Project icon at the top. Now there is one last thing that we need to do, and this is probably the most important step, and it's the one that most people miss. By default, our script doesn't have permission to look at other files in your Google Drive. We need to manually give it access to the Google Drive API service. This is what allows that drive comments list command that we just saw in our comment extractor script to actually work. On the left-hand sidebar, click on the plus icon next to services. This will show you a list of all the Google services that your script can connect to. Scroll down until you find Drive API. Click on that. All you need to do is click the Add button. You'll now see Drive listed under your services. And that's it. Our script now has the ability to request permission to read comments. Now, before we can use the script, we do need to run the script one time in order to grant it the permissions it needs. This is just a one-time setup step. First, make sure your project is saved and make sure you are on the menu.js script. At the top of the editor, you'll see a function drop-down menu. Click it and make sure that onOpen is the selected function. This is the function from our menu.js file. Now just simply click the Run button right next to it. Google will now ask you to authorize the script. So go ahead and click on Review Permissions. Be sure to choose the Google account that you are using for your script and your document. Now, if you are using a personal account, you are almost certainly going to see a big scary warning screen that says Google hasn't verified this app. Please do not worry, this is completely normal and expected. This message appears only because Google hasn't personally reviewed the code that you just pasted in. But you've been through the code. As we just walked through, you can see that it's only designed to create a menu, ask for a URL, and pull comments. So to continue, click on the advanced option at the bottom. Then click on the link that says go to your script name, unsafe. This final screen is the most important one. It shows you exactly what the script needs permission to do. It needs to see, edit, create, and delete your spreadsheets. That's so that it can write the comments into the sheet. And it needs to view and edit files in your Google Drive. That's to actually get the comments. So be sure to tick select all and then click continue. Perfect, the one-time setup is complete. Now for the fun part. All our hard work is about to pay off. We can now use the custom menu button to run our script. So head back to your Google Sheet. You may need to reload the page for the new menu to appear. After a moment, you will see that new menu item right at the end of your toolbar. It'll say Comment Extractor. Now, go to the Google Doc that you want to extract those comments from and copy its full URL from the address bar. Head back to your sheet, click the Comment Extractor menu, and select Export Comments from Doc. And there's our pop-up box from the user input script. Paste the Google Doc URL into the field and click OK. You'll see a little running script message. Just give it a few seconds, and just like that, an export complete message appears. The script has pulled all the data and formatted it for us. Let's click OK and take a look at what we've got. The script firstly clears the sheet every time, so we've always got fresh data. It then goes ahead and creates the four columns, highlighted text, this is the text from the doc that the comment was attached to, comment and reply, author, and our date time column. As you can see, the date is formatted perfectly as year, month, day, hour, minute, which makes it incredibly easy to sort your comments chronologically. It also freezes the top row and makes it bold with a green background so it's easy to read. But here's the best part. The script is smart enough to group comment threads together. You'll see the main comment, and then all of its replies are listed right underneath it, indented a little bit as well so that you can clearly see the conversation flow. To make it even easier to read, that formatting loop that we saw in the code adds alternating background colors and a thick border around each complete comment thread. Now you have a clean, searchable, and shareable archive of every single piece of feedback from that document. And there you have it. In just a few minutes, you've built a powerful custom tool right inside Google Sheets that solves a massive frustration with Google Docs. You can now easily archive feedback, search for specific comments, and share a clean summary with anyone. And you can do it all without downloading any external software or paying for any third-party tools. To get started, just follow the link in the description below to find that Google Doc with all of the code ready to copy and paste. I hope that walking through the code gives you the confidence to use it yourself and even explore what else AppScript can do. And don't forget, if you want a full deep dive into Google AppScript from the very beginnings, be sure to check out the detailed video linked in the description also. Happy scripting, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.